Hey, good to see you.
Hey, man. What's
yeah.
happening?
I want to talk about railways today. It's James.
Hey, how's it going?
This is a nice place. We're close to Saigon Pearl over there. And this is Cafe Bos. How do you say this?
Bosporus.
Bosporus. I lived exactly in this place over there, and it's very nice.
Yeah.
But if you think about it, like, you cannot really exit it, and
yes.
Saigon Pearl is blocking the view.
Well, they say in real estate that a view is a privilege, not a right.
That does make sense.
Yes,
yeah. Cool. Let's get a coffee. Talk about railways. Well, actually, the Saigon subway. Really excited about to hear this. This is legit.
Yeah.
I've never seen this place.
Hey, cafe latte. Mountain.
So this is it?
Yes, this is the proposed map of the new Saigon Metro.
Okay, first, how do you get to have this map in the first place?
It's on my website, so if you click the link underneath thing, you can have a look. There have been a few maps already made that you can find on Wikipedia. I've taken those maps and basically found all the information from the building authority site and made it what it's meant to look like.
Okay, so you took the maps that are already there.
Yes.
Put them all together into this.
Yes.
So, okay, when do you think this is gonna be built like that?
Well, so on this map, the only thing that is actually there at the moment is this black dotted line,
mm-hmm.
which represent the overland line that goes from Saigon to Hanoi.
That's the railway, right?
That's the railway. Mm-hmm. So I've just put it there for reference, even though it's not a useful commuting line because you can't stop anywhere. At the moment, this red line is the only one that's under construction. So it's been proposed to be built for the last 10 years, and every year they say, oh, it's going to be ready in 2 years.
Yeah.
So the last 4 years they've been saying it'll be ready in 2 years. So yeah, we're now in 2018 and they're saying, yeah, 2020 is going to be the date, so I would probably say 2022. But they are building it. There's, if you go down to Bentan Market in the center of Saigon, there's like 30 cranes there, all working over all through the day. So it's, you know, it's happening. As for the rest, like the last news report I saw, maybe 3 years ago, they said, okay, we want this done by 2030. So line two, which was going to go from Bentan out to out here, is like they said they had an official ceremony to start the construction maybe 4 years ago, and then they just stopped, and then they've since realized that there was problems with the design, and they've
mm-hmm.
Now said they're not going to start until 2020. So with all these sort of delays, it's, you know, not going to happen in that sort of time.
How do you think is this planned at all? Does it make sense to you?
It makes sense, yeah. I mean, at the moment, when metros start, they usually just start with a cross. So,
yeah.
Like the first line is not going to make sense at the start. So, the first line is only ever going to serve whoever's on it. So, it's always going to be a tough call. But, you know, the journey of a fully functioning metro system begins with the first line, and then you just keep adding lines to it.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Maybe the first three or four lines even still don't make sense, but then you add a fifth line and all of a sudden it's interconnected with all the other ones, and it becomes like a system that's really useful.
And then more people use it, and then you need more lines.
Absolutely, but it's like we all want something like in, you know, Shanghai or Singapore, where there's just lines everywhere, but they all started with one.
Yeah.
And they weren't useful. They were only useful for those people at line one. And so you've got to start, so in 30 years' time, there is a backbone where you can keep building more lines.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Yeah.
when we drive out to Taoding,
yes,
Taoding and District 2 in general, like there's this line, and to me it looks like along the line there are always these new high rises.
Yes,
it's like, it looks like they're building them according to the line.
Yes,
that might bring up the naughty thought that you would do this in order to raise the prices for the real estate in order to sell more ground.
Absolutely. Well, it's sort of intertwined. It's like everywhere you look, there's going to be development on each line. So it's just a matter of, well, there's obviously going to be people who probably have inside information who will maybe buy up in advance. Even if you just look at this, you know that there's going to be a metro coming. So speculators are like going, well, I'll just buy this block, maybe in 20 years' time there'll be a metro here. And same along here, this is line 2, if it ever gets done, this goes down CMT 8,
okay,
which is like a very busy road.
This is Bentham Market,
yes.
Okay.
And
it goes, this should be District 4 or District 10, or what is this?
No, this is like District 10,
yeah.
So there's the old train station,
mm.
There's a big development happening here, there's the Viettel Tower,
mm-hmm.
And there's a big developments in District 10 happening, but all along here you would expect towering apartments all along there as well. So fair enough, you know, if people want to live by a metro, then that's what we need.
Yeah, so if you're an investor, just go to these points.
Sure.
And just
put
them.
But then
put
it's
a couple
like,
of million each.
How long do you want to wait? Like this line 5 is connected to line 1.
Yeah.
And they raised money for it a few years ago, and they said, okay, this is going to happen, and then same again, it just sort of stopped. So you might have been speculating and thought, oh, let's buy something here, and then you're still waiting for it.
If you look at this, if this would be on the other side, it would look like Berlin, actually.
Yeah.
Same design. The airport here,
yes.
This should be actually one of the first ones to be built, right?
You would think. I think they originally, I found archived articles when they first started talking about building a metro. The first line was going to be from the airport, and then they said, well, you know what, we're going to be building a new airport and it's going to be open soon, so let's not worry about it. And then of course the new airport hasn't even begun to be built yet.
Yeah. Do you know where it should be?
Yeah, it's in it's at like Long Tan, which is
is it like here somewhere?
Yeah, it's going to be out here.
Yeah.
So
it would make sense to build like a branch here.
Yes. They have they've got a proposed line which I'll add on the next map, which goes around the other side of the city, and it'll go to Vung Tau. So
that'd
maybe
be nice.
Yeah, maybe you could then connect to a train here at the airport and go down to Vung Tau. So that
we could
that
finally
would be,
go surfing at Vung Tau.
There you go. Yes, with a train and on one of the psycho vans.
That'll be nice.
Yeah.
You just did it because you liked that. You thought it was necessary.
Yeah.
Why don't they have that?
I think they will have it, but because it's not even built yet. Maybe it's like the last thing we're thinking of.
Okay.
So, like I said, there's like I've seen two maps online, which you can find on the wiki page. And so it's just, you know, other designers who have like taken it into their own hands.
Cool.
And I write about railways in Southeast Asia, and I have a lot of data about the different railways. So it just seemed like the internet needed this. But
okay, yeah, that's cool.
Fair enough. I have a travel blog called Nomadic Notes. So that's sort of one of my blogs. I have several other travel websites.
Super popular.
Yeah, it's okay. And then in the last sort of 6 or 7 years, I've been based in Southeast Asia, and I've sort of taken an interest in the a lot of infrastructure programs that are happening here. It's like a very exciting region to live in, because it's they're starting from so far back in some cities, and there's like just some really interesting things happening. So I like following you know, what's happening here and seeing these cities transform into modern metropolises.
I started to be in Saigon 4 years ago.
Yes.
You came here probably 10, 15 years ago?
No, maybe. Well, I first visited 12 years ago, like just backpacking.
Yeah.
And then I came just before you to like place myself here. So I remember when I was here in 2005, when it was, the roads were much dustier and there was no, well, there was no McDonald's or Starbucks here or anything like that. So there is.
Yeah, I find it's always interesting to see two things, very mundane things. One is the price of a normal coffee.
Yes.
I'd say, like, say the cappuccino, maybe also Café Soda.
Yes.
And the other thing is the level of English that people speak.
Oh,
and I feel like both is leveling up every year.
Yeah. Especially in the urban areas, in Southeast Asia in general, I find people speak far more English than maybe East Asia. So, okay.
Thank you so much, James.
Thank you. Okay.
All right, guys. That was James Clark from nomadicnotes.com. If you're, what do you think about this railroad here? Just write it down in English and Vietnamese. I'm gonna respond myself. And if you like it, share it with your friends and subscribe. See you in the next videos, guys. Bye bye.